I know your type, babe. You like to play games and have it your way. I'll tell you something.
Hey guys, what's up? It's Leyvi, back with another Albion Online guide. In this video, I'm going to show you my personal crafting process and how I make money by crafting. Some of the questions you guys ask the most in the YouTube comments and on my Discord server are how to make money with crafting, is crafting worth it, and what should I craft to make money? And a lot of other similar questions that are about crafting and money making. So I hope this video will cover all of your crafting questions. If you still have any crafting questions after watching this video, or any other questions, make sure to ask them in the comments below and I will do my best to answer them. I hope my start to end process will provide all the necessary information you need so that you can also start making money with crafting, but more importantly, understand how the processes behind it work. Now, my video will be a bit different than usual, because normally I prepare a script and I record that and make the footage later, but this time I'm just going through the process whilst recording. So I will speak my mind, like whatever goes through my mind whilst recording basically, and this might make for some repeats in the things I say, but this might also make for some awkward pauses because I might have to think about what I want to say next. So if that happens, my apologies. And also, I would really appreciate it if you guys would write in the comments below what you think of this video, because it will be very different to my normal videos, and based on your feedback, I might go back to scripted videos for my next videos. If you guys enjoy this type of videos, I might continue making these, so your feedback is deeply appreciated. One last thing before I get to the video. I started streaming on Twitch every Friday and Sunday, so if you want to catch me playing Albion live, make sure to follow me on Twitch. And any extra streaming sessions will be announced on Discord, which will happen, so if you want to catch me live as much as possible, make sure to follow me or join us on Discord, I guess, as well. There's like 800 people on Discord now, so we got quite the community going on. Both Twitch and Discord will be linked in the description below, so oh yeah, and make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you can catch my videos whenever they are uploaded. Let's go back to the topic now. So, I personally craft, what is it called? Plate helmets. As you can see, my plate helmet crafter is at 100. And this is because our guild needed someone to craft helmets for our Rieger program. And I was the one that said, like, hey, I can do helmets, no problem. But just because I cover helmets, like plate helmets in this video, and just because you are about to see what the profit is in plate helmets, doesn't mean it's the only good thing, guys. Let's clear that up, okay? Any of the crafts work, if it's whether it's plate boots, plate armor, a sword, you know, let's see what else. Leather shoes, daggers, I mean everything works, guys. The important thing is that you pick one mastery and stick to it. So for me, it's plate helmet crafter. And you might be like, hey Leyvi, you got some points in plate armor and plate boots as well, but I stopped doing that. That was like a beginner mistake. Just stick to one mastery. Sticking to one mastery will unlock higher tiers, which tends to make for more profit when crafting, but also provides a bunch of bonuses. The first bonus you see here is a 3000 bonus to focus cost efficiency while crafting all plate helmets, which means you need less focus to craft any plate helmet. The second bonus is an increase to quality, and as you guys know, higher quality means more profit. Now that is the mastery, right? So from the mastery you want to pick one and stick to it. And then you have the specializations. Now the helmets have three normal helmets, three artifact helmets, and one Avalonian helmet. Within the specializations, I would suggest beginners to also stick to one specialization at the very start. As you can see, the bonus repeats itself once here again. Same for the what is it called, the quality, but also you have like a specialization bonus, and this one only affects the specialization, and this is like eight times more than the mastery. So this is huge, guys. The 25,000 specialization to focus cost efficiency while crafting knight helmets, that one is really huge. Same for the quality. It's really huge. So I would really suggest to pick one mastery and perhaps pick one specialization at the ferry start and just to stick to it to get as best bonus as possible. And once you have it at a quite high level, perhaps start delving into other specializations within the same mastery. Now that we got it covered, let's get to my crafting process. So, one important thing I need to share with you guys is that when crafting, you want to be at the right place. And what I mean with that is you want to use this wiki page here to see where you need to be to get the good bonus, best bonus. So I'm a plate helmet crafter, and as you can see, Fort Sterling includes plate helmet. And as you can see here, Royal City with bonus, with focus, 48%. Which means that whenever I craft, I get 48% return on the resources I use. And 48% is the maximum. As you can see, Blackstone Hideout also has 48%. But assuming most of you guys are beginners watching this video, you probably don't have access to in Big Alliance in the Black Zone. So you want to stick to the Royal City with bonus. And even if you are in a Big Alliance, it still might be wise to stick to the Royal City with bonus, because traveling within the Black Zone tends to be pretty dangerous. So just stick to the Royal City with bonus, that would be my advice. And I didn't mention it yet, but you definitely want to craft with focus, guys. I mean, the bonus goes to focus to begin with, but also it makes for more return. And you get 10k focus a day, it generates automatically 10k every day, and it caps at 30k. So this only happens when you have premium active, so make sure to have premium. I mean, playing Albion without premium is pretty painful. And honestly, once you get to a certain level, your focus will make much more back for you than whatever your premium costs. Okay, now that we got that covered, let's get going. So I am in the right city, I am in Fort Sterling, where the plate helmet bonus is active. Now the first thing I want to do is go to the market. Now when crafting, one thing is very important. The market changes from day to day, right? There is like no fixed formula for crafting, because the prices, they change a lot from day to day. So you kind of want to check every time you go craft, which would be when you have 30k focus, so once every 3 days, you want to check what item you want to craft. Since I am a plate helmet crafter, what I do is I look for bars. I'm going to look at 8.2 bars and check what they cost, because these are the resources I need, right? I need bars to craft my... So they cost about 77.4k, and I make note of that. So one 8.2 bar is 77k. Now to craft one of the Guardian helmets, Knight helmets, or Soldier helmets, I need 8 of these bars. But as you can see on this website here, with the Royal City with bonus and with focus active, I get 48% back, which means that I get about 4 bars back. So in reality, I need about 4 bars to craft one of these helmets. Since I have the price for a bar noted down, next thing I do is check the Guardian helmet prices. So Guardian helmet right now costs 360k. We note that down and we check the next helmet, which is the Knight helmet. The Knight helmet is 405k, and the last normal helmet is the Soldier helmet, which is 360k. Okay, so let's get the calculator. There we go. So we know that the prices for the helmets are 360k, 405k, and 360k, and we know that the price for a bar is 77k, and we need 4 of these bars for one of these helmets. So 4 times 77 is 308k. Which means that when we craft a Guardian Helmet, we make about 52k profit. When we craft a Knight Helmet, we make almost 100k profit. And when crafting a Soldier Helmet, once again, 52k profit. So crafting Knight Helmets, Guardian Helmets and Soldier Helmets at 8.2 today is a really good choice. And that's what we are going to do. So, what do we need? We need bars, right? But that's not the only thing we need. We also need potato salads, which increases the quality of the items we craft. And we also need journals. Well, normally I would buy these materials and stuff, but I think I have some on the Guild Island. So I'm quickly gonna go check that out. Our Guild Island happens to be located in Fort Sterling, which is good for me, since I can stash all my crafting stuff here. Okay, so what did I need? I needed 8.2 bars. I needed journals. And I needed potato salads. There we go. Quickly gonna check something here. Okay, so this is what we need. We need potato salads to increase the crafting speed and quality. I personally use it more for the crafting quality, but when you craft in huge amounts, the crafting speed is really useful as well. The materials and the journals. Now, I also take generalist journals with me because you fill these both at the same time. So this just makes for more profit. But always make sure to check the prices of the generalist journals because the prices for these are pretty wild in that sometimes the empty journals cost more than the filled journals. Which doesn't make sense, but it happens in Albion. Okay, I don't have a lot of bars, I noticed, so I'm gonna go and buy some anyway. But for my crafting, one potato salad will be enough. As for the journals, it's better to bring too many with you than to bring too few. So I'm gonna go buy some extra of those as well. I have lots to train. So, the first thing I want to do is buy some extra bars. I want to have a total of 40. And before I actually buy it, I must say that putting buy orders for these is much smarter. I mean, if you were to put a buy order now, you would be saving 7k per bar, which is pretty huge, right? If you use 100 bars, that's 700k, so I would suggest to put buy orders. We said we want to have 40, so we have 16, we want to buy 24 more. There we go. So I have 40 bars now. Journals as well, I want to have more of these. I will buy another 16. And let me quickly showcase you guys the difference in price between an empty journal and filled journal. If you aren't convinced about taking journals with you yet. So a tier 6 blacksmith journal. Empty one is 8k. A full one is 16k, 17k. That's about 9k profit. For the tier 7 ones, an empty one is about 13k. A full one is 31k, the profit of 18k. And for the tier 8s, are 28k when empty, and 63k when full, which is 35k, right? I mean, at all tiers, the crafting journals, they always make for profit. Always make sure to have the crafting journals with you. As for the generalist journals, they are a bit different, but when I have them, I always take them with me. And I sometimes check the prices to see if it's worth buying them. So the tier 3 ones I have with me are 900 when empty. And when full, as you can see, they are 900 as well. So, well, a couple of them are. But with the generalist, you want to be more careful. As for the crafting ones, you always want to take them with you. It's a huge part of your profit. Okay, so we basically have everything we need, right? We have our potato salad, we have our bar, our crafting journal, even generalist journal. And we know that, let's go back, we know that we make a profit by crafting these items, right? So this is the point where you are good to go, basically. And that's what we are going to do. Okay, now that we are in Fort Sterling, with focus, with all the items we need, within the right city, because this is the place where Plate Helmet gets a bonus, the next thing we need to do is find a crafting bench. Nowadays you can click on them and it will highlight the ones you need. So this is the one we need, the Elder Warrior's Forge. What we want to do within this is look at the usage fee for users. And this one is 10%, 9%, 10%, like just go through all of them. 46% to find the cheapest one. So 9% it is. We are gonna go to that one. 9% is the cheapest. Alright, now we are at the cheapest place to craft our items. The first thing we want to do is use our potato salad. Now that we have that active, we navigate to the item we want to craft, which is the knight helmet at 0.2. As you can see, the resource return rate is 24%, with the focus active it's 48%, and as you can see, the 9% tax translates to 3.6k silver. So let's quickly note that down. Tax is 4k, and we're starting off with 40 bars. Alright, so I want to craft two knight helmets.
Good choice.
Now that we have done that, we are going for guardian helmets. I also want to craft two of those. And you can see it costs about 1k focus per helmet.
Sure.
And two soldier helmets. There we go.
Good luck.
So this is what we crafted. We crafted one knight helmet, or I mean two knight helmets, two guardian helmets, and two ultra helmets. And if you're wondering why I'm not just crafting knight helmets only, because they obviously make the most profit, it's because you want to target different markets at the same time. So it's better for me to also make some profit on guardian helmets than to only make profit with knight helmet, but maybe not sell all of them. At least that's what I think. So what did we get? We got 6 helmets. We got 10 journals, as you can see here. We also got the generalist ones, but for this video I won't count them, because it's not a standard thing to take those with you. And what did it cost us? It cost us 25 bars. So let's note that down. Cost. 25 bars at 77k each. So 25 times 77, which is 1925. Almost 2 million. What else did we use? We used one potato salad and we used 10 journals. So let's go to the market to check out the price of those. I think the journals were about 27k, but I'm not completely sure. As for the potato salad, I believe it's about 7k. Let's quickly confirm that. Okay, so a potato salad is 6k. And these journals, they were 28k each. So this is our total cost. Let's quickly calculate that. Oh wait, I forgot one thing. The tax. I crafted 6 helmets at 4k tax each. Tax is 6 times 4, which makes for 24k. So the total cost is the bars, or the materials, potato salad, the journals, and the tax. So let's quickly add those up. There we go. The total cost is 2,235k. Now I also used some focus crafting this. Seems like I used about 7k focus. Since the Knight Helmet and Guardian Helmet are maxed, they require less focus, as you could see, but the Soldier Helmet required a bit more. These required about 900, I believe. I didn't check this one, but I assume like 1,200. Okay, so we got the total cost here. Next thing we want to do is see what everything adds up to. So we crafted one Soldier Helmet that's good quality, which is 353k. What about the other one? The other one is excellent. 390k. Let's just add these up. First, oh yeah, and keep in mind, guys, you lose tax when listing things and when selling things, so always account for those as well. So you want to look at the total value here. So 353k. That's the first Soldier Helmet. The second Soldier Helmet is 378k. Actually 87. The two Guardian Helmets are both good quality, which together are about 700k. And then we have an excellent Knight Helmet, which is 678, 79k. And the other Knight Helmet, which is good quality, is 397k. Alright. So those are the prices of the... let's call it gains. Those are the prices of the helmets we crafted. But we also filled 10 of these books. And 10 of these cost 611k. Or at least, that's what we get. Alright, so next thing to do is to add up these prices, right? 353. 178. 698. 697 and 397 and 611. Shit. There we go. So the total gain or the total value is 3,116. I mean, we were a bit lucky with this one being excellent, although this was also excellent. But with the levels I have, crafting excellent really isn't that rare. It happens quite often, to be honest. But as you can see, it just affects the profit you make enormously. Once again, focus on one specialization. So where is my word? It's here. Alright, so we now deduct the cost from the gains. That's the next step. So 3116 minus 2235, 881k. So our total gain is 881k, which cost us 7k focus. Which is insane, right? That's really good money, because I get 10k focus a day. I used like 7k focus, maybe 8k. But if it's like 7k, we get like 1.5 times 800k. Let's say it like that. Like 1.2 million a day by doing this, right? Alright, but we are not done yet. We are not done. Because this is the city where everyone, right? Everyone crafts their plate helmets. Because it provides the bonus to the helmets. So what are we going to do? We are going to the Guild Island first of all, to stash everything. because we're not gonna sell these items here. We are at the Guild Island now, so we're just going to stash everything here. The blacksmith journals. If you have laborers, you can use them yourself, but otherwise you sell them for the profit, of course. But don't teleport with journals, guys. That costs a lot of money. So you just want to teleport with the items you crafted. Depending on how many, of course, because if you have like 100 items crafted, you don't want to teleport with that. You are better off doing a trade run. But if you have like 6 items like me, teleporting to Martlock, which is the royal city on the other side of the continent, only costs us 14k. That's much better than spending like 20 minutes going there with the ox whatsoever. We are just going to teleport there. These 6 items. So once again, the reason we are doing this is because in Fort Stirling, the plate helmet bonus is active, right? And everyone is selling their helmets there, basically. So there is a really big chance we will get more profit selling these helmets somewhere else. And it doesn't have to be Martlock per se. You could check out different markets to get the maximum profit, but I tend to be lazy, so... Like, to be honest, I even list them in Fort Stirling most of the time, because I'm that lazy. Okay, so these were for Fort Stirling. Now we are going to check them for market, so, for Martlock. So the soldier helmet, that's excellent, is 700k. Which was like 378k in Fort Stirling. What a difference. I didn't expect this much of a difference, to be honest. This is pretty shocking. So, 700k. That's like double the price, man. That's crazy. Okay, we're just gonna list this. 678k, actually. Okay. That's one. The second one... Apparently, I was already selling a few of them, but... The second one was 353k in Fort Stirling. Here, it's 358k, so a slight... Light... Profit, 5k, it's very little. Let's list them here anyway. I'm too lazy to go to another city with them. 358k. The excellent soldier helmet, or the knight helmet. It was 680k in Fort Stirling. Okay, I might just want to keep selling that one at Fort Stirling actually. I'm just going to keep it at 679k and not list it here. As for the other knight helmet, it was 397 at Fort Stirling. Here it is 416, so it's a bit of a boost. The journals we don't touch, and the guardian helmets. Together they were 700k in Fort Stirling, here they are 834k. So we're just going to list them here. Okay, let's calculate the profit once again. And once again, guys, if you want to min-max, just go to the different cities, but maybe teleport completely naked and make a note of what they sell for, or use the website where you can see like the different prices, although it's not accurate, which is why I never use it. But yeah, if you want to get the most out of your items that you crafted, just go to the different cities naked and check them out there. I'm just way too lazy for that. But yeah, let's calculate the profit now. So 358 plus 678, 834, 679, 16, and the journals, of course, at 611, 3576k. Which is like 460k more than Fort Stirling. Am I right? 460. Yeah, 460. That's crazy. So let's quickly add that. 460 plus 81. So the total gain by just teleporting from Fort Sterling to Martlock is so much more. I'm gonna deduct the 14k from this, because it costs us 14k to teleport, which brings it to 27, right? So 1,327k profit with 7k focus, which means with 10k focus, let's do x1.5, it's about 2 million profit with just one day worth of focus, which is insane. If you, of course, I'm higher level, but I mean, it's a bit of a grind, but it's nothing too crazy if you ask me, so you will get there in no time. But yeah, like, now you see for yourself how the process is, right? And how much profit there is to be made, but also how to maximize the profit. And honestly, you don't even need to be a crafter to make these profits. Because as you saw, I could have bought the helmets in Fort Sterling as well, and teleported them over to one of the other cities to sell them there instead. So there is a lot of money making with just teleporting items around as well. So that's a bit of a tip if you've been watching this far and are like, I'm not even sure why I'm watching this video, because I don't even like crafting. But there you have like a golden money making. Alright, so you might be like, so Leyvi, you have like 100 specialization, 100 mastery. Of course you're going to be making a lot of profit. So what about I show you guys something lower tier, right? So let's look at one of the helmets I can craft that are lower tier. But one of the, what is it called? The artifact or Avalonian. So the helmet of Valor, right? That's in the plate helmets. Let's check the helmet of Valor. Okay, so the lowest helmet of Valor is a tier 5. Like the cheapest one on the market is a tier 5. But the lowest one is a 4.2. Okay, so a 4.2. Let's quickly note that down. Let's get rid of all of this. A 4.2 helmet of Valor is 450k. Right? And what do you need to craft a helmet of Valor? You need 8 bars. But by now, we know you need about 4 bars. Because you get a 48% resource return rate. When crafting in the right city, which would be Fort Sterling. And you need one Exalted Visor. So, we know the helmet is 450k, an 8.2 bar is, oh shit, I mean a 4.2 bar. 4.2 bar is 2k, so we need 4 of those, which makes for 8k, right? And an Exalted Visor, and an Exalted Visor is 417k, right? So even if you were to craft a 4.2 Exalted Visor, which is like really low entry, right? Like anyone that just started crafting will be quick to craft one of these, because it's only tier 4. Crafting this costs 425k, whereas it sells for 450k, which means you have a 25k profit by just crafting this item. And once again, you can use a journal, which will only increase your crafting, your profits more, right? And also, guys, like, really work with buy orders. I mean, I've been crafting these Helmet of Visors for quite some profit, and I never bought it at 420k. Like, people really sell them for cheap, as you can see here, like 380k, 310k. So make sure to work with buy orders. I mean, that's another, buying it at this price is another 100k profit, right? Or go to different cities and check the prices there. So yeah, let's also do one of the artifact helmets, right? One of the artifact helmets to see if there is any money to be made within low tier artifact helmets. So let's say demon helmet, which is a plate one. Okay, so a regular demon helmet is 28k. I think a 0.2 is good to work with. So a 0.2 demon helmet costs 48k. What do we need for it? Once again, we need 4 bars. We checked these before. 4 bars at 4.2 are 8k, right? We are going to craft with focus, and we are going to craft in 4 sterling, because we are smart. And what else did we need? We needed a tier 4 demonic scrap. A tier 4 demonic scrap costs 17k. Or 19k. Let's just say 17k. Because if we wanted to, we could buy this one. So, crafting a 4.2 demon helmet will cost us 25k. Whilst they sell for 48k. That's another easy 23k profit. So, I really wanted to show you guys that even with lower tier items, you can make a lot of profit. But, as I said before, like, the journals are really important, guys. Don't skip on the journals. Let's quickly check blacksmith. Tier 4 journals. It's 2.5k, 3.3k, 800 silver only profit. Well, if you do it 100 times, I guess it's 80k. So, but yeah, that's basically the process behind crafting, guys. This video was a bit different than usual, as I said before, since I don't have a script prepared. But I'm really curious to what you guys think of this format. So please leave your thoughts about this guide in the comments below. Because it will affect my future videos. If you guys are like, I like this, I might do more videos like this. But if you guys are like, no, I didn't like it, go back to your scripted videos. I will have to do that. You know, whatever brings the best value to you guys. If you have any crafting related questions after watching this video, make sure to ask them in the comments below. I will be happy to answer them. And that was it for today, guys. I hope to see you guys on Twitch or on Discord sometime. And for now, I just wish you guys a good one, and good luck in your adventures, and I'll catch you guys somewhere else next time. Take care, guys.